Yes, in the last class we have seen this Fibonacci series as well as this sum of a digit of a given number. Yes, in the last class we have seen which program? Fibonacci series as well as the sum of a digit of a given number. Now I will continue the same logic with this. Let me see the program 8. We will come to the program 9. These are the two programs which is relevant and very important. It is exist in your practical, I think so. Okay, so I'm copying this and let me take a new document, that is I'm pasting here. Let us see what is a program. So what is the aim of a program here? A program to accept a number and display the number in reverse order. Suppose if I enter a 1 2 3, it has to show 3 2 1. That is our program. The logic is the same. Please observe here, it is the same logic which we have used. Sum of the digit, I am using the same thing and I am doing some little modification. Okay, what is that little modification? You have to pay an attention. So let me type stdio.h and dash include conio.h and this void main. Yes, first what is our program aim? If I enter a number, I want to do the reverse of a number. Okay, so if I enter 1 2 3, what is the output I have to supposed to get? 3 2 1. Got it? That is the reversing of a number. So to do that, first what I am defining, I am defining the required variable. First I am declaring the variable int reverse. I required reverse, remainder and n is we have to supposed to enter the value. Got it? Now I am using the clear screen function. Next I am assigning the value to the reverse as 0. Now I am writing one output statement, enter a number. Now we have to enter in a value from the keyboard. That value is a %d ampersand n. For example, I am entering the n value as 1 2 3. Okay, so if I enter 1 2 3, yes, if I enter 1 2 3, then what happens? Okay, 1 2 3 greater than 0, I am using while condition. 1 2 3 greater than 0, if I did the for yes, 1 2 3 already we have done, right? 1 2 3, I am taking 1 2 3. Now remainder is initially 0. Now let me do that. 1 2 3 greater than 0, taken like this. So if you are getting a confusion, you will take in the form of tabular. Okay, yes. Now enter a number. I have entered the number 1 2 3. While 1 2 3 greater than 0, condition is true, it is entering into the body of a statement. First I am calculating the remainder. Who to calculate the remainder? The entered number percentile 10. If I did, I will calculate the remainder. So if 123 means, then what is the new remainder I am going to be getting? Sorry, it is not as in a 0 0, reverse, and initially it has stored as 0, right? Okay, now remainder 123 percentile 10. So if I divided that number, I will get remainder as 3. Got it? Yes, 3. Next I am calculating one logic. This is the logic for calculating for doing the reversing of a number. So what is the initial value of a reverse? 0. 0 into 10, 0, plus remainder value. What is the new remainder value? 3. In reverse, first it is a 0, now it is going to be storing it as a 3. Okay, for the further continuation of a loop, we have to assign this statement n is equal to n by 10. Then what is the quotient? That is 12, right? So where I am storing? In n. So now what is the new value of n? It is 12. Got it? Yes. Once if it is a 12, control will come to the while loop. 12 greater than 0, condition is true. Yes, if the condition is true, then once again I am dividing, right? 12 percentile 10, it is a divisible, right? Then what is the remainder I am getting? 12 percentile 10, I am getting the remainder as 2. Okay, after that I am going to the reverse. In already reverse we are having value 3. 3 into 10, 30. 30 plus new remainder value is 2. So what we are going to be storing in the reverse? It is 32. Okay, it is reverse 32. Okay, so for the further continuation of that, we have to do n divided by 10. So 12 by 10, then what is the new value? Yes, that is 1, right? Got it? Yes. Now I'm going to while loop. While 1 greater than 0, condition is true. Yes, true. If remainder 1 percentile 10 is 1, got it? So remainder value is 1. 1 percentile 10, 1. Next, 32 into 10, 320. 32. Already reverse values exist, 32, right? 32 into 10, 320. 320 plus remainder, new remainder value is 1. Now, in reverse, what I am storing? 321. Got it? Yes. 321. Got it? And now, let us see. What is the n value? 1. 1 by 10. Whether 1 by 10 is possible? No. Then 1 by 10 is 0. If it is 0, then it comes to the while loop, 0 greater than 0, condition false. Now I am displaying the reverse value. So reverse of number percentile d is reverse. In the reverse, we have got 321. We have entered 123. We got 321. Okay. For this, let me run this program. You will find what we are getting. For this, I am taking the notepad. I am testing. Is there any mistakes? Let me check. Is there any mistakes? No, right? No. Here it is, the mistakes are exist. Let me modify. This is double quotations, okay? Yes, sir. Okay. Now it is a correct. Okay. Now reverse of number percentile d is percentile d. What is the number? It is n, right? N comma reverse. Okay, reverse of 123 is 321. I am getting like that. Okay, yes. I am first saving this file. Where to save? Yes, already you are familiar, right? Even though I am showing you for your understanding purpose, I am going file, I am saving. While saving, you have to confirm it whether you are saving here or not. I am saving it rev.c. What is the program name? Rev.c. Okay, got it. And now I am minimizing this and I am opening my editor. This is my editor. Okay, I am starting and reducing my size and I am opening my file. Okay, what is the file name? Rev.c. Rev.c. So I am pressing the function key F5 for getting the full screen. Now I am compiling. Alt F9. Compiling. Okay, and array number I am entering 1, 2, 3. Sorry, you have to press the number keypad, not as in a number keypad, the above keywords, right? Numbers 1, 2, 3. So if I enter that, it is not showing, right? Why it is not showing? We have not used the get CSV. To view the result, we have to press Alt F5. Okay, the reverse of a num 0 is 320. It has given wrong output because of we made a mistakes. Okay, that mistake is I have used keypad, number pad. I am not supposed to use the number pad. So I am compiling now. And I am entering number 1, 2, 3. Now I am getting reverse of a num 0 is 3, 2, 1. Yes, already in n it is 0, is there, right? For example, to display this reverse of a number, I have to suppose to print here the number. Okay, printf reverse of a number percentile d is, I am placing here num n comma, okay, and I am giving just percentile d, just I am giving here. Okay, I have not given percentile d, I am just giving, I am removing this and I am only giving the reverse. Okay, I am copying, sorry, I am compiling and running, and I am giving the value 1, 2, 3. I am getting 3 to 1. Reverse of num 1, 2, 3 is 3 to 1. Got it? Yes. Likewise, you can execute your program I'm pressing the Alt Enter and I'm coming here and I'm opening my another program. Let me see another program is palindrome or not. This is also very very important program. The logic is the same. Okay, let me copy. You will see what is a palindrome, right? Palindrome means the number. Even if you read it in a either from left to right or right to left, you have to get the same number. That is called as a palindrome. Okay, for example 111. Even if you written even if you read it from left to right, it is a 111. Right to left, it is a 111. Got it? For example, in text, the sum of words are there. Ma'am, what is a ma'am? M-A-M. So even if you read it from left to right or right to left, it is a string, right? It will come same words. For example, liril is also palindrome text. And Malayalam. Okay, so those are the palindrome text. Here it has asked for the palindrome numbers. The logic is the same thing. We have to do a little modification to the above logic. Okay, so I am taking the same thing as include stdio.h and as include conio.h and void main. I'm typing it is small because we know case sensitive. I'm taking the variable as the same, reverse is equal to 0, here remainder and n, and one more variable I'm taking it as an a temp. Okay, here we have to enter a number, that number is 111 and I'm storing that 111 in temp. Okay, afterwards I'm writing the same logic, remainder, reverse and n. Clear? Afterwards I am doing if temp equal to reverse, the given number is palindrome. The given number percentile d is, please observe here it is mistaken, percentile d is palindrome. Okay, the given number else, I am coming here it as an else statement. If the condition is true, it will print like this. If the condition is false, it will print like not palindrome. Percentile D is not palindrome. Clear? Yes. Now let me check. Okay. Yes. Okay. So please observe here. I am entering 123. Where I am storing 123 here. Whether 123 is palindrome? No. Okay. So to test that, first I am checking 123. 123 percentile 10. I am getting the quotient as a 3. 3 into the here reverse into 10, here it is plus. Okay, reverse into 10 plus, not as a by. Okay, so reverse into 10, 0 into 10, 0 plus 3, 3. In reverse, we are storing. Once again, if it want to continue, it has to the 12 greater than 0, 12 percentile 10. Then I'm getting remainder as a 2. Already it will consist of 3, 3 into 10, 30, 30 plus 2, 32. It will be stored in reverse. And here the quotient is 1, right? It will continue. 1 greater than 0, 1 percentile 10, 1. 1 into 10, sorry, 32 into 10, 320. 320 plus 1, 321. Okay, and 1 by 10, it is 0. Now it is comes to the while, 0 greater than 0, condition false. Afterwards it escapes, here it comes. In temporary first, we have stored 123. 123 equal to 321, false. It comes to the else block, given number, 123 is not palindrome. 123 is not a palindrome. Okay, if you want to test once again, you just enter 111. Okay, 111. Got it? Yes. Let me compile and check this program. I'm taking new file. I'm testing. Okay, little modifications here. What we're supposed to do? Otherwise, we are getting an error. You're saying here, yes, okay, and here, okay, yes, sir. After doing this, what we have to do? We have to suppose to save it. Where to save? Okay, whether it requires, anyhow, I will take, okay. Let me go to the file, save. We have to confirm it is in Turbo C, tree bin folder. It is palindrome program, pal.c. okay, now I'm reducing my, okay, now I'm coming here. Was it will get a problem. I'm opening my editor. This is my editor, right? Yes, I'm pressing Alt Enter for the full screen, and I'm opening my file. Now what is the name of a file? Pal.c. okay, now I'm pressing F5 for the full screen. Now I'm compiling and I'm running. If I compile and run, it shows a previous program output. So okay, now I'm giving 123 wrong. Okay, so what I have to do, where to supposed to give the clear screen after the declaration of variable, it is a CLR SSER. Okay, and now we have to come to end of the program. Before the end of the program, it is getch and semicolon, save it, compile it, run it. Okay, now it is asking 123 whether 123 is a palindrome. The given number 123 is not palindrome. Once again, I am running by pressing Ctrl F9. I am giving 111. Whether 111 is palindrome? Yes, got it. So likewise, you can execute your program by using while loop. What is a while loop? While loop is a entry controlling looping statement. Okay, here one more program is given. Let me see, explain this program. And another two programs are there. I will explain two programs. Those are very, very important. I will explain. Okay. Here see this program, program number 6. I'm copying this program 6 and I will explain. Okay. Yes, I'm copying and I'm directly taking notepad. I'm taking new file. I'm pasting here. Okay. What is the name of the program? Program to find sum of a digit of a, not of sum of a digit of a number. It is yes, already we did, I think so, right? Actually we have to take 7th program. Okay, not as in a 6th program. 6th program already we have done, not this one. Let me see here, the 7th program is exist, right? Okay, this is my program. So I'm making it as a documentation part, comment lines, right? Next I will add hash include stdio.h, hash include conio.h, and now void main. Yes, what is the aim of a program? Our aim of a program is find the total and average marks of a student in 6 subjects. So we have to make find total and average marks of a student in 6 subjects. For this, let us see what I did in my programs. What are the variables I did? Okay, I am declaring int marks total, and it is the variable number hyphen underscore, sorry, number underscore of underscore subject. If you are getting this, it is better to have it. How many subjects it has asked for? 6 subjects. Actually we have to declare 6 subjects, but I have not declared 6 subjects. I am taking instead of that one variable as number underscore of underscore subject. Okay, and next here the program name is to calculate the total and average marks. For that average, I am declaring the variable as float average. Point values will come, right? That is why I am taking here. After the variable declaration, what we have to supposed to do? Clear screen. Got it? Yes. Afterwards, in total variable I am assigning 0, in number of subject I am assigning 0. I think better to take it as a 1, 1 less than or equal to 6, right? 1. Okay, now let us see what I am doing. Okay, now I am writing the condition. While number of subject less than or equal to 6, how many subject it has asked? 6 subjects. Got it? We have to enter a subject marks and calculate the total and average. Okay, for this I have taken number of subject as one variable. I am writing the condition as while number of a subject less than or equal to 6, whether the condition is true? 1. 1 less than or equal to 6, condition is true? Yes. It is entering into the block and it is asking for the one output statement I am writing. What is the output I am writing? Enter the marks. So we have to enter the first subject mark. Okay, got it? Enter. If you want confusion, enter percentile D marks comma. Okay, I'm giving number underscore of underscore subject. So if I did like this, what will come? What is the number of subject value initially? 1. Enter the first marks. Get a display as enter the first marks. You are reading the marks from the keyboard. Okay, you are reading the marks from the keyboard and stored in the marks. Okay, clear? It is variable, number of subject variable, and where you are storing the marks value in the marks subject. Afterwards, we have taken the total value as 0, 0 plus whatever the value you have read, it will be added. That will be stored here. Afterwards, I am incrementing the number of subject plus 1. Okay, so it means here it has to give it as plus plus, not as a plus 1, plus plus. Clear? Understand? Yes. Afterwards, where the control will go? It will go to the y. Now, what is the new value of a number of subject? It is 1 plus plus 2. 2 less than or equal to 6. Condition true. Once again, it will enter. It asks enter the percentile marks of a number of subject. That means enter the second marks. You have to enter the second marks. That marks will be stored. Please observe here. Scanf right. Second marks. It will be stored in the marks. Already total consists of a value, total was first subject marks plus whatever the new marks you are entering, right? Likewise, it will repeat for 6 times. After the 7th time, 7 less than or equal to 6, condition is true, false, it will skip. Now I am calculating the average marks, total by your total marks is exist by number of subject. How many subjects? It is a 6. Got it? No, that is why he has made, I think so. It will come as a 7. Isn't it? Okay. Here, please observe here. You have to suppose to make 0 and less than 6. It is a 5. 5 less than 6. 6 less than 6. False. Yes. Please observe here. I am assigning 0 mark, 0 subject mark, it will show as a 0 subject mark. Okay, or else 0 plus 1, let me make here. Let me cut this here, now let it be here only. Now 0th mark, 0 is 1 mark. Okay, next it will come here. Where it is supposed to go? Here. 1 less than 6, enter second mark. Yes. I am cutting this incrementation part and I am placing here. Then if you have made 5 plus 6. Less than 6, correct. Yes, I am making here the incrementation part. Okay. First, what is the initial value? 0. 0 less than 6, condition true. If it is a true, what it is asking? First I am incrementing, right? If it is incrementing 0 plus plus, it is 1. Enter first subject mark. Now I am entering. Okay, if I enter first subject, next here it come 1 less than 6, condition true. Enter second subject, third subject, fourth subject, fifth subject, 5, 6, 6 less than 6, it become false. So that is why here we have to mention less than or equal to 6. If I made it, no, here it is correct. Let me check what it will come. Okay. And now total, I am getting a number of subject as 5, right? 6, right? Okay. Got it. Here it will come 6. 6 less than 6, false. Okay. 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 means total 6 subjects. Got it? Yes. Now I am displaying the total marks and average marks. Yes. Afterwards, I am giving GETCH. GETCH for sorry for this. So this is the program we have to supposed to learn and we have to save here. Okay. It is 6 dot average. I'm giving like that for understanding purpose. I'm opening my editor, Alt Enter, F3, 6 dot average dot c. Is it wrong? What is the name of a file? 6 dot avg dot c. Okay, here I made a mistake. Okay, F3 once again, 6 dot avg dot c. What happened? Does not store 6 dot av dot c. Okay, let me enter F3 6 dot avg dot c. It is not entering 6 to avg dot c is not taken. Let me save as I'm giving it as 6.avg.c. actually it has taken here. Let me see once again. Yes, let me close this editor. If I'm getting a confusion, let me close and minimizing and also I'm closing this file, not required. Okay, let me open my editor, start Turbo C++. I'm opening open 6 to avg dot c. It is not coming. Wow, what is this? Let me save it with some other program as a 6 dot c. Okay, I'm just for understanding purpose only. Let me open 6.c. 6.c. Yes, it is our program, right? I'm compiling and running. First, it is asking enter the marks 1. Enter the first marks. Okay, first subject marks. That means I'm entering it as a 70, 50. I'm giving. Let me enter 50 all for the subject 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right, 6 plus 300 and average is 50. 300 by 6. Correct? Yes, it is right. Got it? So, likewise, you are executing this program. Okay, and let us see the another program of write a program to accept number reverse. We have done write a program to accept number whether check whether palindrome or not. We have done now. It is a program 10. It is a factorial value. Okay. Yes. Let me copy and open a new notepad. And I'm pasting. So, what is a factorial? What do you mean by factorial? Anybody? Yes. Hash include. Let me add stdio.h. Hash include. Unio.h. Yes. Now it is void main and okay, I will explain factorial values. So it's CLR SS here, right? Yes, sir. If you have any doubts in the factorials, let me take here factorial number definition. Okay, yes, you are seeing here in mathematics the product of all positive. What is the definition? Factorial means the product of all positive integer less than or equal to given positive number. Okay, the product of given series number is a factorial number. Got it? Okay, clear? Suppose if I enter 5, it has to do as 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. That is 120. We are getting like this. So these kinds of program is treated as an factorial program, factorial number. To do that factorial number, okay, we have to find what are the factors of a number. For this we have to suppose to write the program. Now I have declared for this we require two variable. We have to enter a number and we have to calculate the factorial. For this I am taking f is equal to 1. Now we have to enter a number from the keyboard. I am first writing an output statement, that is a printf. Enter a number. I am reading a number from the keyboard. Now I am entered number as 5. Now I am writing this. This is the logic for calculating the factorial. Okay. This is the logic for calculating the factorial. While 5 greater than 0, condition is true, right? F is equal to f into n. What is the f value? 1. 1 into 5, 5. Next, I am decrementing. Now it will become 5 minus minus 4. Once again, it will come to the while loop. 4 greater than 0, condition true. It comes to f. F is equal to f into n. 4 into 5, already it is exist, right? 5 into 4, 5 into 4, 20. 20 will be stored in your f, and once again n will be decremented, that is 4 minus minus 3. Once again it will come here, 3 greater than 0, condition true. Here it will come, right? 5 into 4, 5 4 is 20. 20 into 3, 60. Where it will store? 60 will be stored in your f. Once again n minus minus, right? 3 minus minus 2. Once again it will comes to your while loop. While 2 greater than 0, condition true. If condition is true, already in f it is a 60. 60 into 2, 120. That will be stored in your f. N value is a 2. 2 minus minus is 1. Once again it will come here. While 1 greater than 0, condition true. Already in f it is 120. 120 into 1, it is 120. Next, 1 minus minus, that is 0. It will come here. 0 greater than 0, condition false. Okay, so that is the value. Okay, now let me see the execution of this program. I am saving it as a fact.c. I have stored, and I am coming here on enter. And I'm opening file, that is a fact.c. And I'm saved, I'm compiling, and I'm running. If I enter 5, 5 into 4, 5 4 is a 20, 23 is a 60, 62 is a 120, 120 into 1, 120. Yes, it is not get answer. Why? Because we have not given the get CH, right? So to view the result, how to view the result without giving the get CH? Alt F5. So I am pressing once Alt F5, we are getting the output as 120. Suppose if I give the value as a 7 factorial, we will get a sum 5040. Okay, clear? Yes. So that is your program. And next we are moving to next program is this program is very important. Yes, write a program to calculate the square sum of a value from n to 1. This is also one of a very important program. I'm copying, I'm taking here, I'm taking a new file, and I'm pasting. So what is the aim of a program? Square sum of a value from n to 1. Okay, we have to calculate a square sum. Got it? We have to enter a number. That number you have to find square sum. Square means you already know. For example, 2 square 4. Okay, we have to identify that. I will do here, and I'm reading ampersand again. Okay, let me do modification void main, and I'm doing here hash include stdio.h and hash include conio.h. In next void main, enter a number. For doing this logic, we will see what are the variables required. Yes, to do this program. Okay, square sum, 1 square. What is the 1 square value? We have to identify. What is the 2 square value? We have to identify. Okay, for that we have to see here. Okay. For that I am taking n is comma s is equal to 0. Entering a number, I am entering a number as a 4. 4 greater than 0, condition true. Up to 4 series it will come. 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square. Okay. Yes. Now s is equal to 0 plus what is the 4 square value? 4 square 16. Afterwards we are decrementing, right? If it is decremented, now it becomes 3 up to 4 series. 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. So this is the aim of our program. Got it? So for this I am doing 4 square minus afterwards n value. 4 minus minus 3, 3 greater than 0 condition true. 16 plus 3 square, 3 square means 9, 16 plus 9 25, that 25 will store in s, and minus minus 3 minus minus 2, 2 greater than 0 condition true. If it is a true, once again comes here 25 plus 2 square, 2 square means 4. Okay, so did you understand the concept? This means I'm explaining control, and the aim of the program is 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square or plus and so on and so on, okay, up to n series. So here 1 square, control shift plus, here also control shift plus, and here also control shift plus. This is the aim of the program, square sum means. Okay, so likewise we have to evaluate. For this we have written this kind of logic, that much. Okay, now I am giving square of a value percentile d, that is s. So wherever the sum is got, we are having the output up to n series. Up to n series it will access. Now we are giving here clear screen, clr ssr. So hope you understand this concept. If I enter the 4 up to 4 series, 4 square minus 3 square minus 2 square, it will be added. Okay, 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square will be evaluated. Okay, now I am saving this file. I am saving it as sq.c. I am saving it as sq.c. I am opening my editor and I am opening my file sq.c. Now I am pressing, I am entering, running my program. I'm giving the series as 4. So 1 square, what is a 1 square? 1 plus 2 square, 4, 5, right? 1 plus 4, 5, and a 3 square, 9. 5 plus 9, 9 plus 5, 14. 14 plus 14 plus 4, 3 square is a finish, right? 4 square, 16. That means 16 plus 14, 30. Okay. Got it? Square of the value is 30. Clear? Yes, that is the aim of our program, and we have executed this program. Okay, and this is a very, very important program, and some of our programs are exist. We have to calculate this program. So likewise we will explain any number of programs, and here I will explain one small program, not a small program. Already we are familiar with these two programs, so I will let me explain and we will finish this topic here itself only. Here the program aim is Armstrong or not. Okay, so Armstrong or not, dash include stdio.h, dash include ponio.h and void main, and yes, so what is the program here? Armstrong number. Armstrong number means the entered number, summation and cubic. For example, 128 is the Armstrong number. Okay, for example, 128 is the Armstrong number. How I am saying is summation of individual letter cubing. Summation of individual letter 128 is, let me check answer once. Yes, cubing only. 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube, 123. 1 cube, 2 cube, 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 3 cube, 27. 158, I think so. 158. 158 means 128 is a 1 cube 1 plus 2 cube, 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8 plus 8 cube, 8 is a 64 into 8 was it 32. I forgot, let me check here. Okay, Armstrong number, I'm checking Armstrong number definition. See here, 1634 is there. Armstrong number is such that number digit rise at the third power equal to the number. It means 371 is an Armstrong number. 3q 749 27. Yes, let me check here. Calcium I'm taking. I think 153 is the Armstrong number. 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube. Okay, 1 cube means 1, 3 cube means 27, 5 cube means 25. Yes, 153 is the Armstrong number. Please observe here, 153 is the Armstrong number. How it is? 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube. Okay, now 1 cube plus 5 cube. Okay, 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube. What is 1 cube value? 1. 1 plus 5 cube value? 125. 5 is 25, 25 is 125. Plus 3 cube. 3 cube is 9. 27. Okay, 27. 125 plus 25, 150. 150 plus 2, 152. 152 plus 1, 153. Got it? So then what is a Armstrong number? Summation of entered individual cubing is called as summation of entered individual cubing of a number is the same of entered is called as Armstrong number. Okay, so for doing this we are taking a program and variables int n comma a comma s is equal to 0 comma b. Okay, so these are the variables we required. We have to enter a number, and after entering the number b, here I'm storing it is a some temporary variable. Okay, what is b here? It is a temporary variable. In b I'm storing. Now I'm writing the logic. This logic you have seen earlier. I'm writing the same logic. While n, I'm reading value as 153. 153 greater than 0, I am getting the remainder. A is your remainder. Okay, if you are getting a confusion, I'm making it as a rem. Here also it is a rem. Okay, here it is also remainder. Okay, remainder, and here it is also remainder. Okay, yes, now let us see. In 10 comma remainder comma s is the summation and b is the temper. If you are getting confusion, no problem. Okay, b is the temporary variable that I am storing. 153 greater than 0, 153 percentile 10, then I am getting the remainder as a 3, and I am storing sum is equal to 0. 0 plus 3 into 3 into 3, that is 27. I'm storing 27 in yes, and once again I'm doing the remain quotient, that is 15, right? Once again it will comes to the while 15 greater than 0, condition true, 15 percentile 10. I'm getting the remainder as 5. So already here it is consist of 27 plus 5 into 5 into 5. Remainder is 5, right? So 5 into 5 into 5, that is 125. 125 plus 27, 152. I'm storing in S. N is equal to N by 10. For that, quotient is 1. Got it? And once, while it comes to the 1, 1 greater than 0, condition true, 1 percentile 10. 1 percentile 10 is 1. And next year, it comes 152 plus 1 into 1 into 1. 1 cube, that is 152 plus 1, 153, that will be stored in your S. N is equal to N by 10. Okay, 1 by 10 is 0. Once again it will comes to your while loop, and it will execute 1 greater than 0 condition, sorry, 0 greater than 0 condition false. It will skip. In B already we have stored 153, and now I'm checking 153 is and b and 153 in s is equal or not. If it is equal, the entered number is Armstrong, else the entered number is not an Armstrong. Okay, so it is a printing whether it is an Armstrong or not an Armstrong. Clear? Yes. I am doing and I am saving file arm.c. okay, I'm saving arm.c, arm.c, and I am opening my editor. It has closed. Okay, let me open, let me minimize my editor this, and don't record this, and I am opening my editor. This is my editor. I'm starting my editor, and I'm opening my file. What is my file? arm.c. okay, and I'm pressing compiling and running. Now I am entering number 153. Whether 153 is Armstrong number? Yes, we have seen, right? So I have not given the getch. If you give the getch only, you are getting. Okay, here getch, and where we have to suppose to give that value, it is in clear screen, clr scr. Okay, and I'm saving, compiling and running. Now I'm giving 153. The number is Armstrong. Suppose if I enter another number 123, whether 123 is Armstrong? No. Okay, and number is not an Armstrong, likewise it will be evaluated. Clear? And next, what is our last program? This program is write a program to read a number whether the number is perfect or not. Now we will see what is a perfect number. Okay, for this I'm directly taking notepad, I'm pasting. The perfect number is, if you entered a number and entered a number individual summation, if you did the number summation as well as multiplication, even if you did that individual summation and even if you did that individual multiplication, summation and multiplication, if you get the same number, then it is a perfect number. Okay, let me see perfect number. Perfect number, here it is there, perfect number. Here 28 is the perfect number. Okay, so how you can say 6 is a perfect number. Okay, which is the sum of other perfect numbers are 28. How we can say this, we will see. Okay, so according to our logic we will see. Yes, what we have declared here, let us see what are the variables we have declared. In 10 we have to read a value from the keyboard. N means we have to read a value from the keyboard. We have to read a value and we have to store that value. Okay, no, sorry, read and store that value. I am reading it as a 6. No, I am taking it as a 28. Let me check if 28 is a perfect number or not. Okay, 28 greater than 0, 28 percentile 10. First, what I am doing? 28 percentile 10. 28 percentile 10, then what is the remainder? 8. Sum initially it is 0, 0 plus 8, sum is 8. P initial value, I am storing it as a 1. Okay, P for product, S for summation. So summation, if you summation and product of individual entered number is the same, then that number is treated as a perfect number, right? So now 1 into 8, it is 8. Next, for the continuation of a process, n percentile 10, then it is 10 2, right? Quotient is 2. It will come here, 2 greater than 0, condition true, 2 percentile 10. As 2 percentile 10, 2 only. Okay, in E it will store 2. Already in S it consists of 8. 8 plus 2, 10. Is it 8? Remainder is 10, 2 is 28. Yes, 8 plus now 2, 10. Now here it comes. What is the P initial value? It consists of 8 into 2, 16. Now n is equal to n by 10, 2 by 10, 0. What it comes here? Whether 28 is a right prime perfect number? 2 is not a perfect number. That number is not a perfect, it is showing. Let me check if I enter a 6. If I enter a 6, this number I am getting. Okay, let me modify here. Dash include stdio.h dash include unio.h and void main. Here it is there. And let me check. Okay. I am giving here getch and come here. Color is here and I am saving first. Okay, this is the logic we have known. And I am saving per dot c. Saved as per dot c, that indicates the perfect number. I am opening tr dot c. Compiling and I'm running. I'm entering 28. Sorry, the number is perfect number. Control enter number 28. The number is perfect number. Okay, why it is showing 28 is a perfect number? Let me check here. I'm entering the 28. Okay, let me check. I'm running. Enter number 28. Yes. Here it comes, 28% 10. What is the remainder? 28 is the remainder. Yes, here it comes as a 8. Here it comes as a 8 and comes here, right? Here the quotient is 2, right? Here it comes 2 greater than 0, condition true. 2% 10, it is 2. 8 plus 2. Sorry, 2% 10, not possible, right? It will take it as a 1. It is a 2. 8 plus 2, 10. Here, 8 into 2, 16. Not like that. It is missing. The number is not perfect. Okay, here we made a mistake. Okay, so the number is not perfect. Got it? Here it is not perfect. I'm compiling and I'm running. Let me check. Give 1 to 1. The number is not perfect. Okay, here let me check once again. Perfect numbers, other perfect number it is given. Let me try whether 496 is a perfect number or not. Let me compile. 498. The number is not perfect. Where it is missed? The first 10 perfect numbers. It is a perfect number. Perfect number. Programming C. Here it is there. I forget it. Number is there. Okay. You enter that number, it gives a perfect number. For example, if I enter a 6, let me try for the 6. Okay, is there another number? We will try. Okay, let me check for the 6. Left 9, it is a 6. The number is perfect number. How it comes a 6? Let me come here. You have 7. Enter number 6. Enter. Yes, I'm giving here F7. 6% 10, 6 only. S plus A, 0 plus A, 6, 6. 6 into A, 6. 6 by 10, 0. Okay, likewise it is entering. Okay, yes, clear. Yes, I will explain the other perfect number. Maybe I'm getting confusion. Some number is there. You can try for the various perfect numbers also. Okay. So hope you have understood this concept. We will meet in another classes. Thank you for listening.